Today let's talk about the work Subramanyam Chandrasekhar did, which awarded him Nobel Prize in Physics.
In the core of a star, hydrogen atoms are being combined to form helium atoms, and this process gives out energy. This is what we call as nuclear fusion. Nuclear fusion keeps the star going and keeps the star stable, because gravity tries to collapse the star in on itself. But the outward pressure from this nuclear fusion keeps the star stable. But as the star starts to run out of hydrogen, it tries to fuse helium into heavier metals. If the star is less massive than our sun, it would slowly die off as a white dwarf. But if the star is as massive as our sun is, in the later stages of the stellar revolution, it would try to fuse helium into heavier metals and begin to shred large fraction of its mass into the surrounding interstellar space, which we call as planetary nebula. And what remains after this process is just the core of the star, which we call as the white dwarf. When Ceres B, a white dwarf, was observed by astronomers, they found that it had a radius of 4,200 kilometers, which is smaller than Earth's radius, and it was almost as massive as our sun. That means it had a density million times the density of our sun. At that moment, there was no existing theory that could explain this. Irish Fowler and S.Chandrasekhar came along. They used quantum mechanics to solve this problem. As gravity tries to compress white dwarfs further, electrons inside the star hold this compression. How? Let's find out. As the matter inside the star is compressed, electrons get ripped off the atom. What remains is positive ions and a sea of electrons. But these electrons cannot be compressed further because of Pauli exclusion principle, which vaguely says no two identical particles can have the exact same position. So when electrons are being compressed, they try to resist this compression, which produces an outward pressure, and this is called the degeneracy pressure. This is what keeps the star from collapsing. But Chandrasekhar found out this electron degeneracy pressure can only hold a star up to 1.4 solar masses. If a white dwarf crosses this limit, it forms what we now know as neutron star. Or if it's even more massive, it will form a black hole. This limit is now called as Chandrasekhar limit. But if these white dwarf stars have no nuclear fusion going on in their core, what keeps them shining? Even after the death of the star, the core of the star is still very hot because of the past history it had.
That's why it glows. But as time passes on, this white dwarf will slowly cool down and fade out as a black dwarf. But this process takes about trillions of years. That's why we don't see that happening, as the age of the universe is only 13.7 billion years. Please do subscribe to my channel for all the future videos. I make a new video every Thursday. And as always, stay curious, stay awesome.